In this video, I'm going to share why you, yes, you, should get into 3D printing. I'll talk about why I love it and why I think you're going to love it as well. Regardless of whether or not you consider yourself a maker or handy, I'm going to explain some of the reasons why those of us already in this hobby love it so much, and what's more, why you might want to consider picking up your very own 3D printer. Let's dive in. It's an accessible, creative outlet. Personally, I've always been a creator at heart, ever since I was a little kid working in the garage with my dad, learning how to solder or woodwork or whatever it was. Now, whether it's building businesses, creating online courses, or just making pieces of furniture around the house, I find that I'm happiest when I'm creating things. But at some points in my life, creating, especially physical creations, hasn't been that accessible. Now, this could be periods in my business where I needed to focus more on marketing my creations than creating new ones, or periods where I lived in a cramped apartment and didn't have the time to go to a makerspace to get my hands on some actual tools. But that's the beauty of 3D printing. You really don't need 20 of them like I have. These days, you can get or build 3D printers that literally fit on the corner of your desk. And even if you don't know how to design your own files, there are millions of files that you can just download or modify or just print out for just about anything that you could think of. And while you can spend hours building and designing things, even the fastest 3D printers take time to actually print out your stuff, which means that you can scratch your need to create, then, like I do, go focus on your real work while your creations are just printing out in the background. And sure, you could get into scrapbooking or make your own jewelry or something like that, but in terms of the sheer range of things that you can create for a small investment of a few hundred dollars with minimal space, well, 3D printing honestly takes the cake. By the way, if you're not sure exactly what you could 3D print, go ahead and open this video in a new tab to see a list of 50 plus things that you never knew you could 3D print. It saves time and money. Now, people don't talk about this that much because oftentimes the plastic stuff we buy somewhere like IKEA or the dollar store is incredibly cheap, maybe even too cheap, cheaper than it would cost you to 3D print. And that's certainly true for a lot of mass-produced things like storage bins and shoe racks. But in my experience, 3D printing can actually save you a ton of money, not to mention time spent shopping at every different store around town to find exactly what you want. Oftentimes, I'm able to print myself a solution to a problem that is not only cheaper than what I would find in stores, but which I can have in an hour or two instead of waiting a few days or wasting hours of my time trying to find exactly what it is I need. Just take a look at my list of 28 plus 3D printed tools if you haven't seen it already, if you don't believe me. It really does save a ton of money to just print out what you need at home. And this is especially true if you just need a small fix to fix a part of something that you already have, but which the manufacturer may not sell separately. I can't tell you how many times I've been able to save myself from replacing something entirely by being able to print a replacement part. In fact, that reminds me, it's ecological. Okay, I know what you're thinking. How can 3D printing be ecological? I mean, you're basically encouraging people to use plastics, print out more and more stuff that will eventually end up in the landfill, right? No way. First of all, most 3D printing today actually uses PLA, or polylactic acid, which is both made of corn and also is highly recyclable and even compostable with industrial composting. You can even buy filaments that are made of 100% recycled materials, including used water bottles, reclaimed fishing nets, and much more. Plus, you can even send your filament out to be recycled into brand new filament. But that's only part of the reason and part of the story, because you see, 3D printing is good for the environment in actually a bunch of other ways as well. First of all, when you 3D print something at home, you are eliminating the need for that part to be delivered around the world to you by plane, train, and then a delivery driver making a special trip to your house. Not to mention all the packaging, warehousing, and all that other stuff. Sure, you still need to have the filament delivered to your house in a box, but how many parts can you print out of one big order of, say, 5 or 10 kilos of filament? Think of just how many individual boxes and envelopes and how many delivery driver runs that saves. But there's another way that 3D printing saves the environment, and that's by allowing us to fix things instead of replacing them. It may sound unlikely or silly. Yeah, right, Jonathan. Nobody actually does that, you might be thinking. But I honestly can't tell you how many things that I've been able to save from the landfill because I was able to print a replacement part instead of replacing the entire thing. This runs the gamut from mechanical things around the house to tools to pieces of my kids' toys, electronics, and much, much more. Diverse learning opportunities. Now, many of you probably don't know this, but in my past life, I was actually an expert in accelerated learning, and my books and courses on memory improvement and speed reading have actually been enjoyed by hundreds of thousands of people all over the world. So yeah, you can say I kinda like learning new things. Now, typically, because of this, I have a problem where I devour different hobbies really, really quickly. I dive in headfirst, sometimes literally, in the case of acro yoga, and I learn the 20% that gives me 80% fluency in the subject, and then I get bored. See, even if I don't become a master in the subject, like piano or Russian language, I often get bored when the initial challenge and the rapid growth level off. And that's a real shame because it can turn things that really bring me a lot of joy into past hobbies that I no longer really derive any enjoyment from. It's a total bummer. But not with 3D printing. You see, with 3D printing, there's just so much to learn and in so many different areas. If you get bored of printing other people's designs, then you can just go down the rabbit hole of 3D design. If you get bored of that, then you can dive into more exotic materials and master the trickier ones. If you get bored of all of that, well, you can build your own 3D printers from scratch. And of course, because you're always finding new things to print, it's constantly changing. More importantly, you're constantly learning, which makes this a great hobby for kids as well. In 3D printing, you not only learn about engineering, but you also learn about polymer science and computer networking, physics, software, maintenance, and of course, problem solving. Which leads me to solve unique problems. 3D printing is a really powerful tool, largely because it has so much potential. You can print nearly anything that you can imagine, so long as you have a big enough printer and you're willing to make use of things like additional hardware, electronics, and so on. And honestly, that's one thing that I didn't anticipate loving so much about 3D printing, not nearly as much as I do, and that's solving unique problems. You see, like I mentioned before, I grew up with a dad who taught me to solve my own problems with my own hands, whether that meant building a doghouse or fixing my own car or just creating novel solutions to my own problems. But unfortunately, you really need to be a master craftsman to solve a lot of problems with wood, clay, or metal. If I wanted to, say, make a custom compost bin or an intricate tree planter or a tool wall with custom attachment for all my video gear, that would be a really daunting challenge with traditional materials like wood or metal or clay. But not with 3D printing. See, thanks to the power of modern CAD software, even easy-to-use CAD software, plus the versatility of different kinds of plastics, you can do so much more with so much less knowledge and experience. Yeah, it might seem overwhelming to learn one of these scary CAD programs, but I promise you, if you just spend a few hours on YouTube checking out tutorials like Teaching Tech's awesome Onshape tutorial series, linked in the description below, you'll be able to create literally anything that you want or can imagine, even if you, like me, didn't really excel at math, science, or other STEM stuff at school. And again, as I mentioned in my first point, 3D printing, at least for me, is all about learning. So take it as a fun learning challenge and dive in. If you do, you'll come out on the other side with so many unique custom-made solutions to problems you never knew that you could solve yourself. Sure, you can download the ready-made toothpaste squeezers and trash bins and other kinds of really cool camera tripods, but I think that you'll find that the most rewarding part of 3D printing as a whole is when you're able to take advantage of its versatility and accessibility to create your own custom one-off solutions to make your own life and the lives of those around you just a little bit more comfortable or better. Wow, that was a long run-on sentence. But it leads me to community. One of the things I didn't anticipate when I got into 3D printing was just how vibrant and friendly the entire community is. Whether it's on the 3D printing subreddit, on Twitter, on various Discord communities like Polymaker, Prusa3D, or Voron, or just in the comments on various file sharing websites like printables.com. People are just so friendly and helpful in this community. Now, maybe it's because so much of consumer 3D printing's origins all come from open source roots and forums, and the idea of me sharing what I've created with you free of charge so that you can use it, benefit from it, and improve upon it. But aside from a few bad apples and really nasty outliers out there, I've mostly found this community to be some of the finest, friendliest, most enthusiastic people you can imagine. So, which 3D printer should you get? Hopefully, by this point in the video, I've convinced and encouraged you to give 3D printing a try and hopefully see if you love it as much as I do. And if so, the next logical question you're going to have will be, which printer should I get? Well, this is a huge question, and it's going to depend largely on your budget, what you want to print, and how much space you're willing to take up. I really could do a whole separate video on that. But I will say that if you're looking for a great all-around 3D printer that is perfect for beginners without breaking the bank, I can happily and confidently recommend the SV06 or SV06 Plus from Sovel, who was kind enough to sponsor today's video. Allow me to explain why though. The SV06 is basically an exact replica of the legendary Prusa MK3S Plus, long regarded as the best printer on the market, but with injection molded parts and modern mass production methods. That means that it comes in at less than one third of the price of the Prusa, but with the same performance and even better fit and finish. It's not insanely fast like some of the high-end printers and latest greatest ones that I review on the channel, but it is a perfect printer to get you started. And unlike the Prusa, it only takes 20 to 30 minutes to assemble and get up and running. Now, I also mentioned the SV06 Plus, which is Sovel's latest machine that just came out, except it features a larger build area, an easy-to-use touchscreen, a high-flow hot end, and lots of other small upgrades over the SV06. So if you have the space and you want to print things like cosplay helmets or bigger storage solutions, trash bins, and so on, then that's an even better choice. Plus, they're offering the first batch of SV06 Pluses for only $299, which is just insane for the value you get. Thanks to Sovel for making this video possible, and thanks to all of you for watching. I also want to thank my Patreon supporters who make it possible for me to come back every single week, creating content and doing what I love, which is 3D printing and talking about 3D printing. To check out my Patreon, support the channel, and get exclusive perks, discounts, and benefits, hit the link in the description below. Thanks once again for watching, and I'll see all of you on the next layer.